Hi Leo, welcome to Creative Intuition Tarot. My name is MJ. I hope you are well. So Leo, this is your general reading for January 2022. And as a general reading, it can apply to any area of your life. So please take the messages as they feel relevant for you. And we are starting with the theme of the month for you when you have the Hangman, Major Arcana. You are changing your perspective, Leo, or you are entering 2022 with a changed perspective. Your values are flipping over or have flipped over, okay? But the Hangman is also a time of rest, taking a step back, deep meditation, analyzing, thinking, but no action, right? So you are observing. I feel that you are really observing with awareness, with curiosity as well, but you are not taking action yet. You may be preparing yourself to take action. You may be allowing those flipped values to align fully with your life, okay? You are allowing yourself time to embrace that changed perspective, and you are taking the time to really carefully look around you now that you see things from a different angle, from a higher ground as well. You are allowing yourself time to look carefully around and see what is there for you, how your values align to what you see, how does it make you feel, okay? And only when you allow yourself enough time, only then you will be able to take action, right? When you fully align yourself with that changed perspective. You know, typically the Hangman means some kind of sacrifice, okay? But the only sacrifice that I'm getting when I look at this card for you, Leo, is that you are sacrificing the previous version of yourself, but in the long run, it will not feel like a sacrifice. I feel that for a lot of you, it will feel like leaving a burden behind, okay? It may feel like a sacrifice now, but at the end, it will turn out to be of the highest benefit for you, okay? So what else? What else for Leo when it comes to the theme of the month for them? You know, this is Major Arcana, so definitely the changed perspective. This is big, right? This is profound. Like you are really flipping around the way you perceive the world in whatever area of life, right? And then we have the Queen of Pentacles. And the Queen of Pentacles is the most motherly queen for me in the court cards, because she's the home carer, the giver, right? She's creating that welcoming and warm home environment where everyone feels safe and taken care of and well-fed and comforted, okay? But in this particular deck, you can see that this Queen of Pentacles is sitting on like on a desert, holding on to that coin. And she's like thinking about something or rethinking, maybe analyzing. Where is it that she wants to invest that coin? Okay. You know, perhaps for some of you, you may have been giving a lot to others. And perhaps with that Hangman, you are working on creating healthy boundaries. Like you realize that you cannot provide for everyone. Okay? That perhaps it's about setting healthy boundaries, but also priorities. Okay? The Queen of Pentacles has enough resources. It doesn't have to be... or I should say, it's not gender specific, but it is that feminine energy that is caring and nurturing. But the Queen of Pentacles needs to remember that first she needs to provide for herself. And only then she can provide for others. If she drains herself out from her resources of whatever kind, doesn't have to be monetary. When she shares her abundance too generously, there's nothing left for her, right? So perhaps with that hangman, again, as I said, it's about creating healthy boundaries and setting some kind of priorities, and perhaps realizing that, your first and main priority should be yourself and your well-being. It doesn't mean that it makes you selfish, but you need to take care of your health on all levels, right? And that's why it may feel like a sacrifice, because you may be feeling uncomfortable at first, that maybe there's a need to say no sometimes to others, right? But at the end, as I said, it will turn out to be of the best benefit for you. Let's see, what is your key to happiness? Your key to happiness, Leo, in January 2022, what is your key to happiness? King of Swords. The King of Swords is the master of that rational mind space, brilliant, logical, rational mind space, right? But he's also the master of truth and clarity. Now, very interesting for me is that you have the Queen of Pentacles, and then you have the King. So you have the feminine and the masculine energy. And the Queen of Pentacles here is facing the ram. Is that the right word for this animal? That it immediately made me think of the Emperor card. So that ultimate masculine energy, right? And then the key to happiness for you is that masculine energy. I really do think that your key to happiness is setting those healthy boundaries and being firm about it, okay? The King of Swords is communicating. I said truth and clarity are his key values, right? He demands the truth and he demands clarity. And I think that your key to happiness is to communicate clearly those boundaries. It's not only about you creating them in your head. Because the Queen, even though it's that caring energy, but it's less active. Masculine energy is all about taking action, right? So I do feel that not only you need to create those healthy boundaries, set priorities, focus on yourself, okay, and your well-being, but you need to communicate them clearly. So first I said, with the hangman, there is no action. But your key to happiness is to communicate it to the outside world. You know, the King of Swords, because he's the master of that swords element, he is able to use communication words skillfully. So you absolutely will not, and you don't have to hurt anyone by expressing your boundaries and your needs as well. It's not your responsibility to take care of others. Those others also have the responsibility to respect your boundaries and your needs, okay? So definitely in that place of non-action is where you think through your values, set those boundaries, prioritize your well-being, your health on all levels. But then in the place of action, you need to communicate it to the outside world. It can be in your family life, it can be about your work place, right? So you know your situation best, so you know how this message applies to your situation. Let's close it off with some positive affirmation for you. Cultivate and radiate the consciousness of love, that soothing and courage-inducing medicine of the soul. Vibrate peace. Very similar to the hangman, right? They both are in a very similar position. Vibrate peace. Radiate the consciousness of love, which is the Queen of Pentacles, right? But at the same time, Don't be afraid to communicate and express your truth, your authenticity, and your needs to the outside world. I hope that you enjoyed this reading, Leo. As always, please take care of yourself, and I will see you soon. Bye.